There's a quote from Richard Feynman, and he says, the first rule is to never fool yourself. And the second rule is to understand that you are the easiest person to fool. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to be honest with yourself. So many of our problems in our life, myself included, our day-to-day existence, we get blocked because we are not being truthful with ourselves. We tell ourselves rationalizations, white lies, or these huge sweeping overarching lies about our entire reality that keep us from getting what we want. So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to be brutally honest with yourself so that you can start to see results that are gonna make a positive impact in your life. But before we get to that, please use the engagement metrics on your platform to engage with the video. So if that's YouTube, that means subscribing to the YouTube channel, hitting the notification bell so that you can get brand new videos when they come out. If that's Instagram, it's sharing with your friends, posting your story, LinkedIn, wherever you are, use the tools to engage. I'm gonna be cross-posting everywhere, and I'm gonna be honest with myself, telling myself that I fell off putting out videos, but I'm gonna start putting out a bunch more videos, I promise. So why do we lie to ourselves? Why don't we just face the truth and just understand where our gaps are, understand where we're doing things we're not supposed to be doing, understand when we're in situations that we don't want to be in? Why is it that on the one hand, you care about yourself a lot? Like, you want good things to happen. You want your life to turn out well. All you think about pretty much is how your life is going. You're like the center of the universe to you. So why do you lie to yourself? Why don't you just admit what's going wrong and change things? Well, it's kind of that self-centeredness in the universe that you have that causes you to lie to yourself. Because, you know, you're so preoccupied with yourself. You think about your own situation so much that it's hard to face the reality that even though you are super preoccupied to the level of self-obsession, you're still not getting some of the results that you want in your life. Like, that's hard to deal with. That's hard to kind of admit, like, you're in charge of managing your life and you're not doing a good job at it, right? That sucks. So we tell ourselves all these little lies to hide ourselves from the fact that maybe we are mismanaging our life. You know, we'll tell ourselves things like, you know, I'm content with my situation. But really, we're not content with our situation. We are just keeping ourselves from going to another level because we're going to have to make that admission that we're BSing ourselves. We'll tell ourselves that I'm okay in the relationship I'm in. I'm okay in the job I'm in. I'm okay in the life I'm in. I'm doing good. I'm doing fine. Everything will work itself out eventually. I'm going to do the thing. I'm going to start the business events. I'm going to do, but you know, deep down, that there are some issues going on. So what do you actually do to combat this? How do you start telling yourself the truth? Well, in this video, I'm going to walk through some of the favorite things that I did in my own life that helped me become more honest with myself and make changes and share some of those insights with you. So here we go. The first thing that you need to tell yourself and admit to yourself when your life's not going the direction you want it to go in is to just kind of just tell yourself that, yeah, my life is not good right now, right? So when I had no money, when I was struggling, working jobs I hated, dropped out of college, all sorts of things were going wrong. I didn't just keep plodding along like some of my coworkers in the factory that I worked in, who kind of just slept to work and like convinced themselves that everything was cool, that just going to work at the factory was cool, that going to get some drinks at after happy hour was cool, that living like that was cool. I was like, no. I was like, this sucks. I was like, this is not good. I had to look back at my past and realize that I mismanaged my life and it hurt. It didn't feel good. So that, you know, it's kind of like, what is it, an AA or NA? You know, the first step to recovery is admitting you have a problem. The first step to living a better life is to admit that maybe your life is not where it needs to be right now. So a lot of the times I talk about the power of negative emotions. You know, we live in the society that is trying to put a Band-Aid over everything. It's trying to give you a participation trophy. It's trying to make you feel good no matter what you do. It's trying to make you have no personal responsibility. It's trying to have you disassociate your identity with your behaviors, but your behaviors make you who you are. So you have to own up to it. You have to own up to the fact that your life isn't where you want it to be. So that might mean you feel lost. That might mean you feel in a sense of limbo. That might mean that for a little bit of time, you have this sense of uncertainty and uneasiness that comes with admitting that, but it's the first step. So then, after that, you have to go through all the basic steps of self-improvement. You have to ask yourselves questions. What could I be doing better? What areas am I looking to improve? Is it my career? Is it my finances? Is it my health? Is it my relationship? You got to look at the steps in the future and reverse engineer those. And then when you're on the path, you have to continue to be honest with yourself each step of the way. So step one is admitting that you want to change. And then when you're in the process of changing, you have to be honest with yourself about other things. You have to be honest with yourself about how you're going through the process of doing whatever it is you're trying to do when you are trying to make the pivot. So when you want to go do something new, don't lie to yourself and say that you've been putting in enough effort towards that goal when you haven't. Don't lie to yourself and tell yourself that the path, the destination is the problem when the problem is you. Don't say that starting a YouTube channel is too hard. Just say that you didn't work hard enough. I'm working on building a YouTube channel. It's really difficult. It takes a lot of videos and a lot of energy, but I'm not going to blame it on YouTube. Just like I didn't blame my early lack of success in my writing career on the readers or on the platforms that I was writing on, I put the blame on me. So that's another way to be honest with yourself while you're going through the process. You have to be honest with yourself about, your world view as a whole. You know, a lot of people create these elaborate rationalizations about the nature of reality itself to keep them from changing. They blame it on outside circumstances. They blame it on their immutable characteristics. You know, it's very in vogue for me as an African American to blame all the problems in my life based on my skin color. Yes, there are issues that go hand in hand with the way that I look like, but that's not the only reason I wasn't getting results that I wanted in my life. It wasn't the only variable. There are multiple variables. You know, a lot of people talk about the fact that, you know, society, the economy is rigged against the individual's success. And that is actually true. But you got to go another step further and be honest with yourself about whether you're allowing the system to dictate your actions or whether there is an alternative path where you could be making decisions to help free yourself from that system. So that's another huge lie people tell themselves, is that they're trapped underneath this invisible thumb of society, when in reality, you could escape the machine and the machine's not gonna notice when a handful of cogs are missing, right? You have to be willing to change your mind. That's really hard to do. You know, there's this idea of confirmation bias where once you get something in your head, once you believe something to be true, once you have a worldview, once you have a set of beliefs, everything that comes in, pieces of evidence that come in to contradict your worldview, you just filter them out because you want to be consistent with who you are. And it's really hard to change your mind, especially on some of your deep-seated beliefs, but you have to look at the results that you're getting. And that's the way that I've always gazed my life. So I look and I'll ask myself, is my belief producing outcomes that I want? Is a belief that everyone is out to get me going to produce outcomes that I want? Is a belief that I can do nothing to change my situation gonna get me the outcomes that I want? Are those beliefs even true? So it's this process of practicing this radical, brutal honesty with yourself to try to contradict some of those deep-seated beliefs that you have. And I know they're really hard to get out of, but it's the only way. And only you are gonna know the answers to all these questions. Only you are going to know the degree to which your circumstances are getting in your way. Only you are going to know the degree to which your own effort is contributing to your success or lack thereof. Only you are going to be able to know whether or not you're BSing yourself. But just know, as a general rule of thumb, 9 times out of 10, you are. And until you get rid of all these rationalizations, you're not going to be left with the truth. And the truth is that there are things that you want in life that you're currently not doing. There's things about your situation that you would like to change. There are beliefs that are limiting you from doing the things that you want to be doing and the things that you need to be doing. And the ultimate truth that you need to accept is that you are primarily the one getting in your own way. And that circles back to the beginning. Like, that's kind of, that really is the toughest, that is the toughest thing to deal with. The fact that there is a better life out there, there are better results that you could be getting. All the stories that you make up in your head about why you're not winning, it's all BS. You're just not doing it. And you're just kind of letting your life slip by without doing the things you know you need to be doing. And it really hurts to know that about yourself. But then after that, after you take that blow, you can be liberated. You don't have to keep going through that low level of anxiety where people feel in the back of their minds like they know they're BSing themselves, but they're going through the motions every single day. And that pain is going to last with them at a low level for the rest of their lives. You might as well just take it up front. That's what I did a couple years back. I looked at my life. I was not doing anything the right way. And I was like, you know what? Okay, I effed up. It's time to start over now. And through a series of activities and things that I talk about on this channel, I was able to make those things happen. You can do the same, but you have to be honest with yourself. A lot of people like this book, Real Help, An Honest Guide to Self-Improvement, because it kind of prods and pokes at you to confront those things in your mind that you know you need to confront, face those harsh realities so you can change your life. So make sure to go grab that if you haven't already. It's in the link, or the link is in the bio on Instagram. It's in the description on YouTube. Make sure to go check that out. Use all the tools of engagement. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, LinkedIn, Instagram, everything. Make sure to check that out. Gonna get back on the videos. I was a little rusty on this one. Gonna get back. Gonna be consistent. I need to quit BSing myself about my progress and get back on it. So I'll see you on the next video.